Well, hello guys. Long time no see. So today I have a little Halloweeny assortment. You can see I found all the orange shit in my house, and we're gonna do a little Halloween sound assortment. So I have all these items. And we're gonna go through them together and, have a little bit of girl talk. So, if you would like to see my selection of items that I've chosen, just keep watching. Maybe grab a snack or seven, and let's get to it. So, whoopsie daisy. The first item is this Yankee candle. You can see it's been well loved. And this is a spiced pumpkin candle. I am half white, so this is very much part of my culture. I have to rep the pumpkin spice and all that jazz. And I'm quite proud to rep it. So, this one is like a really nice fall scent. Really gets you into that Halloween spirit. It feels like shoving your head inside of a nice pumpkin pie. I really dig that. Again, the Yankee Candle. And this has pure and natural allspice extracts. I'm not going to be eating the candle, so I really don't care about that. Let's see next. We can go with this cup. So as you can see, it's very festive. It's orange, fluorescent orange, with pumpkins and stars. It's kind of like a mason jar style tumbler. It does have a little part for the straw to go in the hole. Can drink, your pumpkin spice latte out of here. Anything. Pretty basic. And it was $3.50. Mucho expensive. I think I got it at the Dollar General. That sounds right. So, now, ooh, okay. I want to talk about this because I'm kind of hungry. So this is just the orange Pyrex Tupperware. If I can open it without causing an eruption. Yay me. Okay. So, I have stuffed this with candy because who doesn't love candy? This year, I think I'm gonna charge children for the candy. Cause a bitch needs money. You come to my house this year, you better have some change. So, in this container, we have some Milky Way. My favorite candy is Milky Way. I love the original. This is the mini dark. But I won't say no, you know? So let's have one. Party. That sounded a little bit like too excited to eat some candy. That was a real moan. I'm so lonely. Okay. It's delicious. Pretty much just been eating something in a lot of my videos at some point. Even if it's just scum, I am putting something in my mouth. Don't know what's wrong with me. Okie dokie. So, the next thing we'll go on to will be this. So this is not really Halloween. This is just what I'm currently reading for the month of October. Well, I'm not gonna finish it in October, but I started it. This is the Sleeping Beauty Trilogy by Anne Rice. And it's I knew what it was. It's basically the story of Sleeping Beauty, but instead of her being woken up by, like, you know, a kiss or something, she gets woken up by, like, being boned and stuff, dirty things. And it's like smutty. It's good smut so far, you know. If you liked 50 Shades of Grey, which I didn't really read or like, I read little cliff notes and watched the movie, but it's not really me. So far, this is pretty, you know, dirty. And I'm a fan of that. So we'll see how it goes. It is three different books. It's like one of her being awakened. The next is like, maybe, hold on, let's see. I can tell you, actually. The second book, Punishment. The second book is The Punishment. So I'm guessing they're gonna get extra naughty in this book. I don't know. We'll have to wait and see. So far, though, the prince kind of seems like an asshole. But, you know, some women are into that. So. So, The Punishment. And then the next one, the first one is Upstairs, where, you know, I read and slumber. And this is the release, I guess. This is when she breaks free from him and is liberated, maybe. Who knows? Someone's probably gonna ruin it for me in the comments. That's okay. Okay, guys. So the next item is this voodoo doll. I've had this for years now. I got it in New Orleans. The guy looked like kind of like a cracked out Johnny Depp, so kind of hot, you know. Maybe had like a couple teeth, but it gave him character. This is. There's all sorts of voodoo dolls. There's happy ones. But if you know me, why would you pick a happy one? So, I got the Spellbound Bitch handcrafted voodoo doll. So, it says your doll is a medium to focus on a problem. Something, something. You can personalize it with hair, which I don't really just keep people's hair, so that's out of the question. A small photo or any small personal item. So, I guess what you do is if you're really mad at someone, you just grab something of theirs and you put the bad juju on them. There's no one I really dislike that much, so this is mostly just memorabilia for me, a souvenir. I've never really put it into action yet, but I'm still young, so we'll see. Okay, I don't even know where this came from. This is just a black plate thingy I found, and I was like, that could make nice sounds. It looks kind of beat up right now, but it's, you know, black and orange. It's very Halloween. We just randomly had this. This is not for food use, apparently, but I'm a rebel. I break all the rules. Like with that pillow back there, I took off the tag that said not to take it off. I'm pretty much like a badass at this point. So, if you were wondering where I've been, I did buy a new car. So I've been having, you know, that was fun, but money. I'm gonna be paying for it for a minute. And I had a little mini breakdown, maybe. Not breakdown, but I was like, So when that happens, I tend to kind of withdraw. I'm not the kind of person, and there's nothing wrong if you are. I can't go to social media and like tell people if I'm upset or anything. So I just kind of wallow and die alone. I'm gonna put this up. Next item is just this vase I found. And I put some little baby skulls in it. I just had lying around. They just look like this, my little friends. I had an eyeball, it looks real, it's like a prosthetic eyeball. It has like the veins and stuff coming out and the optic nerve. But I couldn't find it. And I really wanted to show you guys. But this random flower vase with plastic skulls will have to suffice. So as far as Halloween-y stuff, I've gone to a pumpkin patch. I went to a haunted house. Well, it's a factory, but they turn it into like a haunted place. Even though it's technically really haunted, because people have died from like shrapnel and stuff exploding and all that. I didn't really feel, you know, a presence there, but maybe my radar was off. So, let's see. I'm gonna save the pumpkins for last. I picked this pillow, and I know it's not really super Halloween-y, but it has skulls on it, and that's kind of, you know, goes goes along with it. It's more Sugar Scully, Day of the Dead. But you can see it has like some pretty designs. And has purple, black, orange, green on this side. It's nice and fluffy. And then when you turn it around, you have like a Sugar Skull playing guitar, some kind of, you know, instrument. And it has white background, so the colors, I feel like, pop really nice. I got this on clearance at Ross, and Ross has like the best deals ever. Now, if you shop at Ross like on Black Friday, you know, never get into a fight on Black Friday at Ross or Walmart, because people who shop at like Ross and Walmart on Black Friday, usually like they fight with knives, and it is just not worth it. So go any other day and get some great deals, okay? I think this pillow was like maybe, I don't know, $4, $3. Enough where it didn't break the bank for me. So last thing I'm going to show you, don't cry, are these pumpkins. So when I went to the pumpkin patch, I went with my little baby cousins, my sister, and my aunt. But I don't really call her my aunt because we're kind of close in age, and I don't know, I can call her my aunt. She's my aunt in my heart. So we picked out these two pumpkins. I don't know if there's much sound coming from tapping on a gourd. Hope you have a gourd day. Okay. But I'm thinking maybe we can like paint these. It might be kind of hard. I've never carved a tinier pumpkin. But we can try. And, you know, I kind of really do like the woody pumpkins, like the ones that look like they have herpes. But everybody else, they think that they're ugly. And, I succumbed to peer pressure and I got a regular pumpkin. So we're gonna figure out, I might carve them, paint them. But what I definitely will do is whenever you get your pumpkins and you know you're gutting them, don't throw away the seeds, because if you bake them, they're so delicious. You could put whatever kind of seasonings you want. If you just want to do salt, maybe some pepper, maybe put some allspice for that fall kind of kick, you know? The world is your oyster. Create your own reality. You can do whatever you want to your pumpkin seeds, but you definitely should at least, you know, bake them. Snack on them. So I think that wraps up my little Halloween collection, sounds, what have you. I hope that you enjoyed spending some time with me. I hope to make more videos. Sometimes my mind, it just goes places, and I apologize for that, but I'll never officially leave, so you don't have to worry about that. So I love you guys. I hope your Halloween is gonna be just fantastic. probably not gonna dress up this year. I'm probably just gonna be drunk for Halloween. And that sounds fun. So, I'll see you in the next video. And I love you guys. Bye.